Alright guys, so I hope that you've been keeping up with me. We're on the last set with the rope. So far we've done the rope, we've done the bar, the straight bar, the V bar, and now the rope. We're going to do four sets again of 12 on this. I'll stop at 100 in order to keep my form and be able to finish all 12 reps. We have one more exercise after this. It's the one arm rows. So we'll be doing that with the dumbbell. So remember to hydrate. Let's finish out the last set, and then let's go over to the benches and close it out with one arm rows. Support. Me personally, I like to use my own body for support. But if you were to use the bench, this would be the form. So your knee is going to go here. Make sure your back is flat. And the weight is going to be on your side. So if you're going to use the bench, make sure the weight is close to your body. You pull up. Remember, you squeeze at the end of the movement and then release. So it shouldn't be like this. You pull something like that, nice and slow, concentrating on each rep. Okay? That's if you want to use the bench. Again, I use the bench sometimes, but I like to use my own body weight. I'm going to do 12 reps. This is the first set. First set down. Three more sets. sets. We're going to increase in weight. So pick your poison. I like to do this weight and go up to about 100. So my fourth set will probably be ending with the 100-pound dumbbell. We're at 50 here. So 50, I guess 65, maybe 75 will be my next set. I like to jump up and go ahead and do it, get it out the way. So I'll probably do 75 for my next set, and the other two will be at 100. So, but that being said, I don't want you to do a weight that you can't handle. Just because that's the weight that I can handle, you may not be able to handle that. I want you to pick a weight that you can complete 12 reps and have good form. Okay, so if you feel that you can't get the dumbbell all the way up and it's a strain, the weight is probably too heavy. So you will get more progress doing proper form than you could do by lifting something heavier and your form is really nasty and messy. So I'm going to pick 75. You go ahead and pick your weight, and let's do our second set. If I can find a 75. That's all right. I see a 70. Here we go. So your rest periods are going to be about a minute, 30 seconds to a minute, depending on how heavy you are, though. The heavier exercises usually require a little bit more time and rest, maybe 2 minutes. But in general, about 30 seconds to a minute and a half is a good rest period. But it doesn't give you a lot of time to chatter. Second set. Is looking kind of heavy now. Well, the thing is, too, if you find that you choose a weight in it, you can get the first couple of reps off. Do the first couple of reps and then lower the weight. Isn't that simple enough? You don't have to do the whole set if you can't do it right, but lower the weight. So I'll start at 100. If I can't do all 12, then I'll lower it. Third set, come on.
Right here.
All the guys are so nice to me at the gym. They blow my head up kind of big. But I appreciate all the love. All right, guys, get your mind right.
Nobody can do what you can. Now, the female, some of the male, too.
Yeah, you're right.
Well, that's the only way to go. I say either go hard or stay on the treadmill. All right, guys. Third set, come on. Get your mind right. Get all the negativity out of your head. You can do it. All right, come on.
The flash has been turned off.
Burn some calories before them hot dogs and bacon time, you know what I mean?
It won't be none of that for me.
Not for you, right? You got competition coming out soon?
What you mean?
Oh, yeah, you definitely stay away from
me. All right, guys. Let's get it done. I'm a little tired. The last exercise done, and it's the last rep. Last set, I mean. Get your minds right. Come on, we got this. Me and you together. All right? Come on.
Yeah, don't worry. Don't pay me no mind, man. I'm trying to get the lighting on. Come on, my lady. Yeah, I know. With my eyeball.
On your upper and lower or your abdominis rectus, and of course your obliques on the side. So you want to do things like crunches, maybe some knee raises, some leg raises. That's going to take care of the center part, your abdominis rectus, or what we know as our six-pack. And then you might want to do some, I'm trying to catch my breath and talk too, you might want to do some side work. Side bends or lateral bends, trunk twists, these type of things bring that waist in nice. So take those into consideration as you're doing your ab work. And of course, some cardio of your choice. The best type of cardio, of course, is HIIT. No, not HIIT like hit somebody. High intensity interval training. So fast, slow. If you don't know, Google it up, HIIT. To find out exactly how to do it, but it's just a combination of going as fast as you can for a certain amount of seconds, and then slowing it down, slowing your heart rate down for a certain amount of seconds, and then repeating that process for a certain amount of minutes. So look it up, HIIT, H-I-I-T, do that for your cardio. It's more effective than the regular cardio that you may do. So again, I do thank y'all guys for joining me for my upper back workout. 15 days out to Pittsburgh. Continue to follow me every day. It's going to be really exciting as I take you along with me to Pittsburgh. So, stay tuned. Tomorrow's workout is back again, but lower back. We'll be doing some deadlifts and some bent over rows. So, rest up, eat well, drink a lot of water, and I'll see you tomorrow.
thank you.
Okay, nice. Okay. I don't want to stop. Yeah, this camera. It has a mind of its own.